My name is Will. This is Esther.
Good morning, everybody.
And this is Kanga. And we're part of an innovative mobile medical team set up to tackle human African trypanosomiasis, better known as sleeping sickness.
Donc là, on est allé faire un petit bâche pour protéger, donc on est allé pour la peau.
The mobile team works hand in hand with national sleeping sickness control programs in Central Africa, where the disease is prevalent. We travel by plane, 4x4 vehicles, and even dug out wooden canoes to reach the few remaining areas where transmission of the disease is still active.
So over the recent years, the numbers of reported sleeping sickness cases have reduced each year. Now we are around 7,000 reported cases of sleeping sickness per year. The real number is probably around 3 times higher because the screening is incomplete. So if we are to treat all those remaining cases, and we're also able to reduce the number of tsetseflies, which transmit the disease, then elimination, sustained elimination is there, it's feasible.
The mobile sleeping sickness team is made up of MSF doctors, laboratory technicians and logisticians, all working hand in hand with national control programs.
In this area here you get a collection of people from different villages, and while they're here in this area they carry the parasites in their blood and their tsetse flies typically along the river. And tsetse fly will take the parasite and pass it on to the next person.
Our aim is simple, to save lives and to contribute towards the sustained elimination of this deadly, neglected tropical disease. But to do so, we need your help.
The national sleeping sickness programs are severely under-resourced and understaffed and underfunded. They are the people in these programs that need to do the work tackling sleeping sickness. So what needs to happen is that these national sleeping sickness programs need to be adequately resourced.
We try to encourage the village to come down in their pirogues to be screened tomorrow morning at the larger village. So we called through to the screening team who are further upriver, finishing off screening in another village, to stop by here this afternoon to screen everybody. So then we make sure we get as many people screened as possible.
It's a big challenge both medically and logistically. Around 15 to 20 staff need to be transported to carry out a screening.
The screening boat is just arriving in the background. We've come to pick up a patient. This is a patient we found 2 days ago with sleeping sickness. So we determined his phase to see how advanced the disease was, and he's a phase 2. That means that the disease is quite advanced. It's spread to the brain, and we need to transport him for treatment as quickly as possible.
Parce que j'étais dans un engoutement qui me fait. Je ne savais pas que là c'est ma femme, là c'est mon frère.
Diagnosis requires sensitive laboratory equipment like centrifuges, microscopes, not to mention a painful and invasive injection in the spine known as a lumbar puncture.
So the current tools that we have to diagnose and to treat sleeping sickness save lives, but they are inadequate for the areas where the disease is most prevalent. For example, to diagnose sleeping sickness, we still have to rely on very complex, outdated methods of using lumbar puncture and microscopy on the fluid that you acquire from a lumbar puncture. This is the same method that was used in the early 1900s. What we need is a rapid test, like the ones used in malaria, and an oral treatment in tablet form.
It's not easy, but it's worth it when a person's life is saved. And knowing we've removed one of the last remaining parasite reservoirs and are one step closer towards putting end to this killer disease.
Now is a pivotal moment. In January 2012, leading organizations, governments and pharmaceutical companies agreed to eliminate 5 neglected tropical diseases by 2020. And sleeping sickness is among them. Yet the gap between this ambition and the reality we see on the ground is striking.
The World Health Organization has issued a high alert for the risk of a new epidemic for sleeping sickness in South Sudan. the mobile sleeping sickness team are setting up a project to tackle the problem in the areas of central, eastern and western equatorial states, during which we'll work with international experts testing a new and innovative trap that hopes to reduce the numbers of the tsetse fly.
So at the moment there are very few NGOs involved in sleeping sickness control. And this is a very exciting thing to be part of, actually, reaching sustained elimination of a disease that is severely neglected. So we really encourage other NGOs to get involved in sleeping sickness care.
When we talk about neglected disease, we're essentially talking about neglecting the health needs of some of the world's most vulnerable people. Tackling sleeping sickness is about changing this. This is what drives me to overcome the daily challenges, and it's an exciting thing to be a part of making history. You can find out more by following my blog.
With joint and sustained action, sleeping sickness can be made history, and you can make the difference.